What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. I'm Katya. Today's lesson is going to be very different. It's gonna be musical and I hope uplifting. Today we're going to learn English with the help of Taylor Swift and her beautiful song Coney Island. Thanks, Valeria, for giving me this wonderful idea in the comments down below. I'm so excited about it and can't wait to get started. So, are you ready to boost your vocabulary while having a good time? If so, grab your notebook and let's dive in. Firstly, I want to say that I love listening to songs in English. Not only do they cheer me up, but also greatly expand my vocabulary. But to make it happen, it's essential to read the lyrics of the song you like and look up words you don't know. Having a great deal of curiosity is essential. And after having worked on the lyrics and listening to the song hundreds of times and singing along to it, I can guarantee that remembering new vocabulary will be a piece of cake. Now I want to explain why I have chosen Coney Island for this very first video. First of all, I've been a huge fan of Taylor Swift since her first album. I've listened to all her albums. I love the fact that she writes her own songs and how she expresses feelings and emotions through her music. Also, I feel very identified with many of her songs. They get to my heart, make me feel, and I can easily relate to its characters. I reckon the purpose of music is to move something inside you, and her songs definitely do. On top of that, she's a source of inspiration for me because she's immensely talented and her endless creativity inspires me. Last year, Taylor Swift made the most of the lockdown by releasing two albums. I spent last summer listening to Folklore and I was over the moon when she unexpectedly released her latest album, Evermore, last Christmas. So the song Coney Island is from her brand new album, Evermore. I think it's super rich in vocabulary, its topic is universal and easily relatable. It's a duo with American band The National. Thanks to the song, I discovered a new music band, and I must admit that I love the voice of Matt Berninger. I think it's very special, unique, and different. First, I recommend listening to the song. You can find the link in the description box, and after that, continue watching the lesson. I've split the song into two parts. First, we're going to focus on the vocabulary, and after that, on its meaning. First, I'm going to read the first verse, and then we're going to learn some interesting vocabulary from here. Break my soul into looking for you, but you're right here. If I can't relate to you anymore, then who am I related to? And if this is the long haul, how do we get here so soon? Did I close my fist around something delicate? Did I shatter you? Now we're going to look at some interesting vocabulary from the first verse. Here we've got an advanced phrasal verb, level C1, to relate to someone. It means to understand someone's situation or someone's feelings because you have experienced something similar before. We have two interesting nouns. The first one is haul, which means a journey, especially a difficult one. Then we've got a part of our body, fist, which is your hand with your fingers held tightly in. And also we have a very interesting and advanced adjective, delicate, level C1. It means something that needs to be dealt with carefully. And we have some collocations, like for example, a delicate matter or situation. And Taylor Swift has a song called delicate that I like a lot. And one verb, to shatter, which means to severely damage something. Now we're going to look at the chorus, and I'm sitting on the bench in Coney Island wondering, where did my baby go? The fast times, the bright lights, the merry-go. Sorry for not making you my centerfold. Over and over. Lost again with no surprises, disappointments, close your eyes, and it gets colder and colder when the sun goes down. So here we have a very interesting grammar aspect about what preposition to use with island when we have the name of the island. I was very confused. I know that it's on the island, okay, the preposition on, but I was always confused, okay, what preposition do I have to use if we have the name of the island? For example, Sardinia. Is it I'm in Sardinia Island, or is it I'm on Sardinia Island? So remember that if you have just island, is on the island. But if there is a name of the island, is in. So remember, I'm in Coney Island. So I think this song helps you a lot with that. Also, we have a very common verb, which is to wonder. It means to ask yourself questions. For example, I wonder what happened to him. Also, we have a noun, the merry-go. It's a short version of the merry-go-round, and it's a machine that can be found at a fair. And last but not least, a centerfold. It's a picture that covers the two central pages of a magazine. In this case, it has a figurative meaning, which is main, principal, or important. So let's move on to the second verse. The question pounds my head. What's a lifetime of achievement if I pushed you to the edge, but you were too polite to leave me? And do you miss the rogue who coaxed you into paradise and left you there? Will you forgive my soul when you are too wise to trust me and too old to care? 'Cause we were like the mall before the internet. It was the one place to be. The mischief, the gift wrapped suburban dreams. Sorry for not winning you an arcade ring. And now we're going to look at seven interesting words from the second verse. The first one, the verb to pound, which means to hit very hard. And pounding the head means very aggressive thinking about something. And then we have a very interesting expression, a lifetime of achievement, which means all your achievements over a lifetime. Then we have a very advanced noun, rogue. It's a person who behaves badly, but who you still like. Then we have the verb to coax, which means to persuade someone gently to do something or to go somewhere by being kind and patient. And the preposition we have to use is into, to coax someone into something. Let's move on to mischief, which means behavior, especially of a child, that is slightly bad and causes trouble, but is not intended to harm anyone. Once again, we've got a very interesting and advanced adjective, suburban, which means something that is boring and not exciting. And the last noun, arcade. Arcade is a fun place where you can play games and video games. And I suppose that an arcade ring is something you can win as a prize in this place. Correct me if I'm mistaken. And now let's look at the last verse. Were you waiting at our old spot in the tree line by the gold clock? Did I leave you hanging every single day? Were you standing in the hallway with a big cake, happy birthday? Did I paint your bluest skies the darkest gray? A universe away. And when I got into the accident, the sight that flashed before me was your face. But when I walked up to the podium, I think that I forgot to say your name. Here I've chosen three words. The first one is tree line. It's in the mountain where the trees end and it's just grass and rocks. In this context, I suppose that they are surrounded by trees. The second one is to hang someone, which means to leave someone waiting for a long time. And last but not least, to flash, level C2, means to move very fast. So in total, we've learned 19 words. Now we're going to focus on the meaning of the song. I haven't read any reviews of Coney Island in order not to be influenced by anyone, and I want to give you my input on this song. First, if you wonder where Coney Island is, I didn't know that before. It's in New York, and as you may know, I want to go there. So when I'm in New York, I'll make sure I go to Coney Island, sit on the bench and listen to this beautiful song. Secondly, it's very cold in the song, like right now here in Spain, and actually my hands are super cold right now. And the atmosphere is very gloomy and sad, and this thing, it gets colder and colder. So I think it's about a long-term relationship that is no longer vibrant or exciting, and they use the adjective suburban, which is boring. So I suppose they have been together for many years and they drifted apart. They started to take each other for granted and stopped admiring each other. As we can see, they aren't excited about sharing each other's success as they sing, but when I walked up to the podium, I think that I forgot to say your name. The relationship went stale, and the song is about its decline. As they say, did I paint your bluest skies the darkest gray? So, as we can see, they don't seem to be happy together anymore. To cut a long story short, I think right now they are reflecting on what to do next. To break up or to give this relationship a second chance. Personally, I think they'll end up splitting up. So guys, please let me know in the comments below how you interpret this song. I'd love to read your ideas. And also please let me know if you enjoyed this new format of the video and if you want to continue learning new vocabulary through music, check out my Instagram account, EnglishBits_, and there I teach new vocabulary every day and usually through music. And I really hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did making it. If you did, please don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up and share it with your friends and family who like Taylor Swift. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!